prefer events that are more just fun events, activities, like some, do you, let me reword that, do you prefer events that are philanthropic, or do you just prefer fun events? So like late night would be the fun event, or like a philanthropic organization would be like Ball State University Dance Marathon or something. So like do you look like the events that have like a cause to them, or just like the fun events? Which one do you prefer?
The ones that are fun. Because your fun is all night of
my own. Yeah. And like I feel like for me, I'm a part of the Dance Marathon, and you're like seeing these kids being helped like by palliative care, and by, and palliative care is for families that are like after care. So like what, like the care that the family gets after the child has passed, and like I think that's so rewarding because they're literally like they like need so much help and counseling and this. Different aspects of life because they're going through so much. The fun events, I feel like those can be offered like just with, I mean, the benefits of going to these philanthropic organizations and stuff.
Yeah, and I feel like, I don't know, like with a normal student, like they don't know like everything that happens with the philanthropic events, like how they're getting help, so it's like, It's like the students are like ignorant to it, but not like to say like they're like not smart, like they just don't know. Like they don't know like what goes into it. So I think that like at first glance they'll look at the fun events, but then like when they learn about Dance Marathon, like what goes into Dance Marathon, I think that's what draws more people to go to philanthropic.
Yeah. And like those, like if that person goes to them that doesn't have prior knowledge to the philanthropic event, they're more likely to like support that cause after the fact. For sure. Do you only attend events for the benefits or to be educated? So like, I mean, that can be both ways. Like you can have events that are for education and that are for benefits. I mean, you're stretching your knowledge, as they say. So what do y'all think about that? Like, do you go to events that benefit you or to benefit, I mean, benefiting your knowledge is the same thing.
I don't know many, like, college students who would just go to something just to, like, learn more.
Yeah.
They're so busy, like, anyway.
Yeah.
Like, you get emails all the time and it's like, come to this lecture on whatever, and it's like, you could not pay me to go to that. Like, even if there were benefits, it's kind of just like, I think people are more willing to go to something if there are benefits rather than just to like learn something new.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, it has to be worth your time because we're stretched so thin anyway, but you have to choose wisely.
Yeah, like, I honestly think there's so much in my schedule. And just like personal experience, like we have to prioritize everything so we can just like fit in so much. Like I remember freshman year, just like being like, oh, I can do this, and like sign up for so many activities, and then it's like junior, senior year, it's like, oh my gosh, you're just so bogged down in schoolwork.
If it benefits you though, because like you said, if there's something that benefits you, yeah, you're learning about it, which like right now I'm looking for a job, I went to a lecture the other day because it gave me opportunities for a job, so I'm definitely going to go to it. So,
mm-hmm.
I like to go to lectures and learn stuff.
Yeah.
I enjoy learning things. I guess I'm a nerd, but that's what I like to do.
Great, good for you.
Yeah. I think the education aspect is, I think it's a component of when people go to those lectures, they're learning and they're benefiting themselves for their future. So I think it can go both ways. So another question we have is, do your friends attending an event determine if you attend? So if your friends go, are you gonna go? I honestly think that when my friends attend, like I'm like, oh, I'll just go tag along with them. But what do you think?
If it's something like I'm on the fence about going, And then if somebody hits me, I'm like, oh, I'm going to this, I'll host like the job.
Yeah, most people don't just want to go to something by themselves, so if they know people go,
yeah.
Do you prefer there to be a guest speaker or more interactive? So would you rather do like little games?
Like, would you have this to be like just a speech, or would you guys like to talk? Like no talk? No talk.
Talking.
You like talking?
Mm-hmm.
You learn more about other people.
Our group has been devising a program to get smokers to quit. We would like your honest feedback. As a student on campus, what are prime locations, in your opinion, for events like this? So we can have it in like Brewers, Ball Gym, different places like that. So what do y'all think, like, where would be the prime place, in your own opinion, of where to have these events? Or like where to have informative discussions or storyboards or poster boards actually about smoking.
Atrium.
Why would you say the atrium?
It's less formal, but it gives you more chance to talk and interact with.
Yeah. They have thousands of customers going out of that door every single day going to class for students.
What about the chirp light?
Yeah, that's good.
So you think that's effective? But when it's cold, obviously. I just walk by and act like I have my headphones in. But when it's warm, I think it's effective.
Do a library right there. They don't do a bunch of stuff inside, right? Walking doors. Because it's going to be okay with some of the sun.
I feel like the scramble light's good to add because it's so busy during the, like, middle of the day, you see a lot of people, but most people, like, they're on a time crunch and they're going somewhere.
Yeah.
Or if I get awkward if I'm out there by myself and there's like a booth set up and I like take the long way around well,
yeah,
not to go over there, it's like, I don't know.
Yeah, for sure.
So you think A-train's like the main?
Yeah.
Everyone agree? Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like everybody's on the hustle and bustle when they run across that scramble. Like, they're just going to class and not trying to stop. And I mean, I remember one time trying to, like, they're selling hot chocolate, right, trying to get me to buy hot chocolate, and walking it down on me and everything, and I'm like, I don't know, it gets awkward sometimes.
You have to cut out.
Yeah. All right, when you're noticing events on a bulletin board, what do you, or being promoted, what do you pay attention to the most? So, like, on a bulletin board, word of mouth, flyers, Atrium table, social media. So what do you pay attention the most to when you see a promotion?
Pictures.
Pictures?
Pictures. Videos.
Videos? Or do you see pictures?
Something that grabs your attention.
Yeah.
You can just glance at it and then go on your way, you don't sit
yeah.
there and read it.
Like that old saying, pictures are about 1,000 words. And why do you say videos?
Something interactive to get you involved
with,
better than just sitting there reading something boring.
What about social media? What, like, social media thinks works the best? Twitter, Instagram? I think they're all pretty effective, but what's, like, the main one that you would listen to?
I would say Facebook.
That's
because you can get, like, the pictures, the videos.
That's true,
the
time.
The wall posts.
Yeah.
I would say avoid email at all costs because
okay.
we all get so many emails every day that
that's true.
It's just, like, a constant delete.
I would say Twitter. Facebook is really effective, but I feel like more people nowadays use
on Twitter.
Yeah.
Oh, Facebook. And I feel like Twitter just like you can just blow up something really
yeah.
fast.
And yeah.
And they're making like a lot of
yeah.
new updates.
Yeah.
Giving you a chance to get a lot of things.
So Twitter and Facebook. That's good to know.
All right. So do you believe that a flash mob is out of our style? Like why?
Do you believe they're out of style?
Yeah, do you think they're out of style?
What if you saw it in the atrium? We just like busted out and we're like, we're here at the atrium. We're here.
Okay, I'm sorry.
We talked about this the other day and our professor doesn't think flash mobs are a good thing. But then we're all up here like,
I watch it.
I know, but if
you were good, like if you were like stuck to dancing, I'd keep walking. But if you were good,
it's a good way to get on social media too. Yeah. You can have it found out.
Take a picture. Yeah.
If it's done really well, then it's successful.
You know, it's break dancing.
Yeah. You know, like why it's happening. Like I've seen them before, and like people are dancing, and there's no reason for it. Like you have to have like somehow say that this is your group doing.
But if we all had like the same shirts on and like
had like
a cigarette or something.
Same dressed as cigarettes.
Dressed like cigarette, I can just imagine.
I mean, I would watch that.
Have like a filter on our head.
You have the Charlie the Cardinal and then the cigarette. And have like the Mortal Kombat theme song.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
That's a good idea.
You're our
promoter. I
have
a
man. You got the dance portion. You get really creative with the flash mob.
Alright, good. So
it's
not out of style.
Great.
Okay, with quitting smoking, would you prefer personal assistance with quitting workshops or more like large scale events? So like counseling groups. I mean, there's like small groups. I mean, there's it's counseling center that has like groups like for smoking cessation for students. But there's like, I mean, there's workshops and there's large scale events like to help the well-being or something. Isn't that what it's called?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what would y'all prefer?
Small scale account is a lot better than a big group to get lost
there. Sure. But do you feel like a large scale event would be more informative?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. No, what do you think?
No, that's what I thought you were talking about.
Like,
you-